At MATTR, we build infrastructure for verifiable data and digital trust. Hi, I'm Claire, CEO at MATTR. Based in New Zealand, we work with the global standards community as well as with customers locally and globally. We specialise in meeting people and organisations where they are, giving them the tools to break silos and build bridges to unlock value. Our focus is on building practical capabilities that work for governments, enterprises and people. The DHS SVIP programme's given us the opportunity to validate our work with many different experts from government and industry. We've been able to collaborate with our customer, USCIS, to discover novel ways for our capabilities to support business value. We've also had the chance to test and learn from the practicalities of USCIS's security, field and operational requirements. We then feed these learnings back into our work in the standards community and ultimately our product. The programme has also given us the opportunity to showcase our work on a global stage, drawing attention to important issues such as digital inclusion and privacy. So what have we been doing? Our initial project focused on delivering capabilities to USCIS to support people in performing essential work during pandemic conditions. The solution focused on allowing USCIS to safely and securely manage access for individuals with authorised appointments related to employment, citizenship and immigration. We showcased this work at the DHS-sponsored Interoperability Plug Fest, where we also demonstrated digital vaccination certificates and visa credentials. Entering phase two of the programme, we're now expanding the scope to include support for all kinds of credential types within USCIS. To support a wide variety of business needs, we're building a general framework for business stakeholders to select from a variety of credential lifecycle features and implementation patterns. With that, I'll introduce and turn over to Nader, who'll provide some examples of the work we've been doing.
Thanks, Claire. Across all of our capabilities, we combine the power of credentials with digital identity to create more trustworthy and resilient systems for people on the web. Credentials enable sets of information to be augmented with additional layers of value, integrity, and assurance, while digital identity supports the security and accountability of all parties in an ecosystem. We think of a credential as a way to encompass any kind of signed data that is used to prove things about real-world entities. With this in mind, let's look at some different ways this comes to life with practical examples. One important aspect of our approach is bridging technological gaps with well-thought-out and easy-to-use infrastructure. Instead of inventing an entirely new system to deal with authentication and data management, we've integrated with a popular identity protocol known as OpenID Connect, or OIDC. In phase one of our work, we built a solution for managing USCIS appointments. By leveraging our OIDC bridge, our system allows an applicant to claim an appointment credential from the USCIS website and then use that credential to verify their appointment with a USCIS officer. This solution shows how we can integrate with legacy systems to create compatibility at the protocol or back-end layer and provide tools for greater control and transparency. In order to prevent these credentials from being misused, we provided USCIS with the capability to revoke completed or canceled appointment credentials. We also implemented selective disclosure features, helping applicants to preserve privacy and minimize data. Key to our approach is bridging real-world human concerns in order to meet people where they are. We can't always expect systems to be fully digital or even online. To support these kinds of use cases, we've developed the ability to issue and verify paper-based credentials. During the DHS Interoperability Plugfest, we demonstrated a solution for vaccination certificates. Although a controversial topic, allowing people to safely share information about their testing or vaccination status needs a general approach which can work globally. Using semantic compression technology to render credentials as QR codes that can be printed, we're able to offer a parallel journey alongside the digital-first approach using smartphones. In our demo, we see how an individual can use a physical vaccination card to claim both a digital and paper-based vaccination certificate. We also see how both types of credentials can be verified by the same relying party infrastructure. This use case highlights the importance of meeting people where they are by providing upgrade journeys which adapt to people's needs. Recently, we extended our capabilities to support digital COVID certificates, or DCC, which have emerged as a central adoption requirement for enterprises and people in the European Union. Using the same set of underlying capabilities related to the management of keys and data, we can offer upgrade journeys with common verification infrastructure across different formats. We also utilize an approach of incremental adoption across our capabilities. Hybrid solutions that are custom fit to each use case allow us to meet the unique constraints of a given problem area while allowing for future innovations. In the second phase of our work with USCIS, we're tackling document notarization. While existing notarization processes work with physical documents, they don't always transfer well to a digital context. You can scan a notarized document and create a PDF, but the PDF doesn't carry the same assurances and guarantees as a physical document. One way to solve this is by creating a verifiable credential that carries the PDF image within it. Claims about the document are added to the credential, covering the notarization output, process, and history. These claims can then be verified by scanning a QR code on the document. This way, an officer can notarize both digital and physical documents using stamps and digital signatures to ensure content integrity and express levels of assurance. This process shows how legacy systems can be adapted and extended to suit the needs of an organization. In this case, notarization has a number of legal and regulatory requirements that dictate how a credential would be used. For example, notarized documents are often presented in court proceedings and government applications. These guarantees are assurances around the authenticity of a document or its binding or authentication process, help businesses and people assess risk and make trust-based decisions. Our solution combines paper-based credentials with digital tools and metadata to create a digital twin for paper-based documents. It's a hybrid solution that uses the best qualities of both methods. We're also applying many of these capabilities and concepts to supply chain use cases. A central tenet of our approach is to minimize the complexity of adopting and using our technology. Interoperability is central to our work with DHS. As part of the SVIP cohort, we participated in developing standardized issuance and verification patterns to support multiple separate vendor implementations. Through agreed-upon open-source test suites, different vendors were able to align their solutions together in a simple and straightforward fashion. If you have time to review our video, you will follow the journey of a user as they claim a credential from a different vendor into our wallet and then present that same credential to another vendor for verification, all using standardized issuance and verification patterns. The demo shows, first, how generalized patterns for managing credentials allow us to interoperate with each other, and second, the importance of user privacy and the ability to perform selective disclosure. Our generalized key management architecture gives us the flexibility to use different security features, such as selective disclosure, without breaking existing patterns or needing to build new workflows and processes. Today, we've seen how these approaches contribute to a holistic framework which prioritizes building bridges rather than creating silos and meets businesses and people where they are. Our generalized capabilities can be utilized across a variety of use cases and a range of different credentials. This flexibility informs our solution approaches, helping to clarify what the best tool for the job is and how to tackle and solve our most important challenges. Thanks for joining us today. To wrap up, we've rounded up some key resources that we hope flesh out and expand the material we've covered in our chat. This includes MATTR Learn, tutorials, papers, and more. Thanks for watching. Reach out to us at info@matter.global or visit matter.global to learn more.